Didn't you catch me, Bunce?
I didn't know you were going to fall, boss.
See me in my room later, Butterfingers.
Oh, no, boss. Anything but that.
This is Christmas. I'll leave out the thumbscrews.
Thank you, Mr. Constantine. Thank you very much.
Georgie!
Hey, Georgie. Get the boss.
Oh, sorry, boss. Oh, thank you, boss. It's through there, boss.
Come along, darling.
Go, go, go. On the arm that comes, under the arm that comes.
You should go and get Mr. C's luggage, and then you can start unloading the rest of the gear.
Right. Come on, Judy.
Capital. Capital. What do you think of it, Colette, my darling?
It is horrible. It is too small. Not nearly as nice as your place, Connie. Why do we have to come here for Christmas?
I told you. We are throwing a party.
We could have had it at your house.
Not this kind of party.
Who is coming anyway?
Merely some business associates.
How boring. It sounds deadly.
You could be right, my little one.
The Christmas tree. The very embodiment of the festive season. Put it in the corner, there's a good boy.
And once again, the Oxford Street stores are claiming record sales. A plea for sensible and sober motoring aimed at everyone intending to drive during the Christmas period was issued today by Sir Frank Hammer, the Commissioner of the Metropolitan Police. In his statement, the commissioner said that past experience has shown that over the holiday
period... Georgie! Sir Kelly!
...the breathalyzer alone is not in itself...
I wish you'd just change channels like everybody else.
Fetch another television, Georgie.
Come, Sherry. While the boys are getting everything ready, you and I will go upstairs and have a refreshing afternoon nap.
These refreshing afternoon naps, they are so exhausting.
First time we met at Bernard Manning's cabaret.
You
Anything ready for us, Mr. C?
Yes, Nico. Ask the boys to come in.
Run along and powder your nose, my dear.
My nose does not need powdering.
Then go and powder some other part of your net.
Don't insist, darling.
Come in, gentlemen. Allow me to offer you some refreshment.
It may have crossed your minds to wonder what we are doing in this house.
It never crossed mine, boss.
Understandably.
Ours not to reason why. Ours but to duff up anyone you're jealous to.
Very well put, Bunce. Georgie. Sit down, gentlemen. Just this once.
So, just exactly where are we, Mr. C? I mean, whose pad is this?
It belongs to a gentleman by the name of Sir Henry Jarvis Brooke, who is currently spending his Yuletide in the south of France.
It's nice of him to lend it to us, boss.
Extremely. Even though he is unaware of it. Georgie, you would enjoy your lollipop much more if you were to remove the wrapper.
So, who's this party made of, Mr. C? Who's it for?
The guests of honor are Dr. Razor Fraser and Mr. Charlie Coffin.
Them slags? But they're two biggest villains in London apart from you, Mr. C.
Flatterer.
What do you want to invite them for, boss, after all the dirty tricks they pulled on us?
Because it is a season of goodwill to all men, when all hatreds must be set aside, old scores forgotten. A spirit of brotherly love must prevail.
So you decided to forgive them?
Yes, Bunce. Then kill them. Georgie, you have got your lollipop upside down.
I've got the scene. This leaves you the top banana. We get them boozed up, off guard. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, then we blast them, right?
Wrong. These gentlemen are our guests. We could not possibly raise a finger to them. It would not be etiquette. Which is why I have engaged two outsiders, hitmen, to come and perform this simple task on our behalf.
Now, boss, you're a spoilsport.
I'd love to see the look on Sir Watson's face when he comes home. What a Christmas box. He finds an house full of corpses.
An entertaining thought, Nico. And no way can the deceased be traced back to our good selves.
You're a genius, boss. And intelligent.
Hey. How are we going to know these hitmen, Mr. C?
They will arrive in some innocent guise, so as not to alarm our guests. They will identify themselves by using the code phrase Jingle Bells. A nice Christmassy touch, don't you think?
You got a smashing sense of humor, boss. Jingle Bells. I still wish you let us knock off Jock and Charlie, though.
Really? Well, in order to avoid any of you getting carried away, I think it would be sensible if you were to hand over your weapons. Nico. And you, Georgie. All of it, Georgie. Hey. Excellent. Now none of us will be led into temptation.
Yeah. How do you suppose these hit men will go about it, Mr. C?
If they enter into the party spirit, there should not be any problem. They might even suggest a little game of pass the parcel bomb. Musical electric chairs.
Or even Irish roulette.
What's that then, boss?
The same as Russian roulette, except that five chambers are loaded and only one is empty.
Blow your brains out doing that.
You don't know this at all, my dear Bunce.
Your postman's not with an hammer.
Ah, the first arrival. Get rid of those things, Nickel. Colette, my dear, I believe our guests are beginning to arrive.
Poor dear, eh? I bet you're wondering how she managed to press the doorbell, Jimmy.
Well, well, Mr. Fraser. So nice to see you. Do come in.
Bring her in, lads. Sweet Chrissy Pressy for you, Jimmy. Don't worry, it's not a booby trap. She's perfectly harmless.
Magnificent. Just look at that classic bust.
Aye, not bad for a wee girl from Paisley. Name's Maggie, by the by.
Enchanted.
Likewise, I'm sure.
Ah. Allow me to introduce you to my little friend, Colette Latour.
Froggy Bint, eh? Classy. They call me Jock the Razor, Fraser.
Droll. Why do they call you the Razor?
It's a sort of an in-joke. I keep people in stitches.
I must say, I love your frog. I've always said black suits the older woman. It's sweet of you to say so. Your dress is also very chic. My, how you say, char lady, Edouard, just like it. When they were in fashion.
I can see you two girls are going to get on famous. Now perhaps you would all like to freshen up before joining me for drinks.
Good idea, Jimmy. Use, fetch the bags.
Please show our guests to their home, Colette, my sweet.
Of course, Thierry. This way.
Au revoir.
Après vous. You're welcome. Monsieur Reza Fraser.
Everything all right, Mr. C?
Yes, thank you, Nico.
Blimey. What's this in?
It's a very famous sculpture, my dear Bunce. A present to me from Mr. Fraser.
Yeah, I thought that was kept in some big museum in France.
It was, Nico. Jock must have had a recent holiday in Paris.
Look, her arms is broke off. Them baggage handlers at East Row want nodding.
How do I look, Ken?
Why do you insist on wearing that stupid gear?
Well, how else are folk to know that I'm not a Cessnech?
That's a good question.
Anyway, this is the proper attire for a low-end Scot.
More like a low-life Scot.
You're just jealous because that French bit of Constantine fences me.
Well, why shouldn't she? They eat snails, don't they? Can't understand is why they gave him that statue after all the bother we had nicking it.
It's not given, love. Only lent. When we go, we take it with us.
What's he gonna say about that?
He'll not be in no position to say nothing. It's not only the turkey that's getting carved up this Christmas.
You mean you're gonna do a man?
Aye. Him and his lads.
That's you all over. Hell bent for pleasure.
Come in. What do you want, Jimmy?
Yeah, Jock. Did you know that Charlie Coffin was coming to the shindig?
Charlie Coffin?
Aye, straight up. I saw him arrive about a quarter of an hour ago.
Father Christmas has been awful good to me this year. Now we can get rid of all the opposition in one go.
Yes, Jimmy.
Thank you.
I really appreciate you asking us down for this party, Mr. Constantine. Soon as we're in the same way of business, I feel I can relax amongst friends. Let me air down, so to speak.
I can assure you it's a great pleasure having you here, Mr. Coffin. Or may I call you Charlie?
Coffin seems so somber.
Well, not a joyful name, I agree. But then I'm not a joyful man. Am I, Mum?
Oh, I don't know. You split your sides when Granny fell down the stairs.
Well, so did she. All over the carpet.
Why don't you make yourself at home? Sit down. Let me get you a drink. What do you fancy?
I don't suppose you've got any meths.
But I could send out for some. Any particular vintage?
Don't bother. I'll have a short. Give us a scotch.
Certainly, dear friend.
Have a seat.
Feel safer with me back against the wall. Check it.
Very cautious man, Mr. Coffin.
Habit, I'm afraid. You see, when I was a little boy of four, my old mum stood me on the mantelpiece and said, "Jump, son, don't worry, I'll catch her." I jumped, she stepped back, I fell in the grate.
Right, Mum? Right, son.
That taught me a valuable lesson. Never trust no one, not even your own mum.
Wasn't that a very cruel thing to do?
No, the fire wasn't lit.
Mr. Constantine. Well, well. You're full of surprises. I had no idea that my old mate was here. How's yourself, Jimmy?
Can't complain, Jock, old chum.
I'm glad to see that wee nick I gave you is healed up nice. It's purely an accident, believe me. Somebody jogged my arm. I'll say one thing, though. It adds character to your moosh.
Now, who hasn't got a drink? Bantz!
Yes,
Bantz!
Yes, boss.
Go and get some more ice, as a good fellow.
Yes, boss.
Bantz! Idiot!
Yes, boss.
I'm sure we are going to have a wonderful evening. What's your poison?
Wondering if you could help us. Our motorbike has run out of petrol a couple of miles down the road.
Shove off. Sling your up.
Well, that's nice, isn't it? It's supposed to be Christmas. Season of goodwill. Jingle bells and all that.
Hey, hey. What do you say?
He says jingle bells and all that.
That's right. Jingle bells.
Blimey, I'm sorry, gents. You should have said that straight away.
police coming.
Not very much.
Expect you like a drink and something to eat before you get cracking, eh?
Oh, smash it.
Get stuck in, Andy.
Well, that is exceedingly kind of you, sir. I take it you are the gentleman of the house?
Oh, no. That is my boss, Mr. Constantine.
Oh. Well, perhaps I'd better explain why we're dressed like this.
No need. Mum's a word. Least said, soon as mended. Not as good as a wink to a blind horse. Well, the eye don't see, right?
Ah, of course, if you put it like that, we agree, don't we, Gaylord?
Eh? Oh, yeah, yeah. Can't make a silk purse out of a silver lining.
Don't make yourself at home, gents. I'll go and let the boss know you're here.
Yeah, don't forget, a stitch in time gathers no moss.
Very true. Excuse me, gents.
He's a nice, kind gentleman, isn't he, Dad? Fancy asking us in for a free nosh.
Yeah, it's like I always say. The British aristocracy are the salt of the earth. It's what they call nobles oblige. It's French. It means the toffs have got to look after the likes of us.
You don't half know some stuff, Dad.
Yeah, and lucky for you, I do, seeing as it was you that got us the bullet from that department store. A whole week slaving away in Santa's Fairy Grotto and not a penny to show for it.
Oh, was it my fault?
No. Well, who was it, may I ask, gripped that little chap by the scruff of his neck, dragged him in, sat him on my knee, then stuffed him down the elves' wishing well because he said he wanted a 6-foot blonde for Christmas?
Well, how was I to know it was Ronnie Corbett?
You like how we feel?
Oh, thank you.
Slow, quick, slow. And this will make you laugh. We filled his wellies with cement and then sent him out for a little swim. It cured him of grassing. In fact, it cured him of everything.
Absolutely fascinating, Mr. Coffin. And what was your next, little kipper?
Well, after the bank job, what was the Hatton Garden raid? Right, lads?
Right.
Have you known Jock for long?
We met at last year's Rangers Celtic football match. He was beating up the referee at the time. He looked up, our eyes met. He threw me a wee love token, and I knew we were made for each other.
What did he throw you?
The referee's left ear.
Deep down, he's just an old softy. This is not an excuse me, Bunks.
So I have a word, boss.
Excuse me, my dear.
Certainly.
What is it?
Shh. Jingle bells.
They are here.
In the kitchen.
I was not expecting them so early. I'm going to see them straight away. Tell Nico to follow me.
Right, boss.
Mum would enjoy this, wouldn't she, Dad? Bags of grub and free booze.
Yeah, bless her heart. I wonder what she's having for Christmas dinner.
I don't know. I've never been in Holloway.
Good evening.
Hey, you're not laughing at my dad, I hope. There's no call for that, you know.
Now, Gaylord, don't get cross. You must forgive Gaylord, gentlemen. He's inclined to be a bit short-tempered, a bit quick on the draw, as you might say.
Yeah, that's right.
I do apologise. No offence meant. It's just that I find your costume somewhat surprising.
Oh,
Oh, well, we've just come off a job.
Really? Your services must be in great demand.
Well, I suppose you could say that. I mean, we've had a lot of experience. Not everyone's got a flair for it, you see. Some of them need a lot of coaxing.
Yeah, they get the wind up and burst out crying sometimes.
You actually enjoy doing it?
Oh, yeah, we love it. Don't we, son?
Yeah, I like to see the look on their faces when we give them their little surprise packet.
God!
That's very rewarding.
Did your last job go smoothly?
Up to a point, yeah, but I must admit, Gaylord lost his cool a bit towards the end of the day. I can't blame him, really. I mean, we must have done God knows how many by then.
Yeah, it was murder.
It was this little bloke that caused all the trouble. Gaylord dragged him in, screaming and shouting, you know how some of them are. And that's when it happened.
What happened?
He said something he shouldn't, so I shoved him down a well.
And then?
It's a bullet.
Fired immediately.
I see you two gentlemen are thorough professionals. I hope you will perform the job as efficiently for me.
Same as the last one, you mean?
Exactly. My guests are not expecting you. It will be quite a surprise for them.
Shut up! We'd be delighted. A very happy arrangement all round, sir.
As to the financial remuneration, you will be happy with 10?
Oh, more than happy, sir. It's very generous, isn't it, son?
Yes, matching.
You will receive half now and the other half on completion, Nickel.
£5,000, gents.
You mean 5,000?
It's all here. You can't if you want to.
No, it's all right. I trust you. I pride myself on knowing an honest place when I see one.
Good. The matter is now in your hands. Proceed when and how you wish. I do not wish to know any details. As long as it is curtains for Messrs. Coffin and Fraser.
Curtain? Oh, yeah. We'll arrange that, all right.
I really must congratulate you, gentlemen, on your very clever masquerade. If I didn't know better, I would believe you to be two absolute cretins.
Thank you very much indeed, sir. It's real, son. It's real money. 5,000 smackers.
Blimey, I haven't seen that much since the last time we played Monopoly. What'd you give us all that for, Dad?
There's only one possible explanation. It's the dream of a lifetime come true. I've finally met one.
Met one what?
An eccentric millionaire. It's gotta be. That's the sort of thing they do, go around lashing out money to people.
Well, I don't know about that. All I know is his potty. What does he want us to give curtains to his mates for?
You can't account for his actions. That's what makes him eccentric.
He could do anything then.
Yeah.
Like come back here and take the money away again.
That's right. I'll be back to Scarborough before he gets a chance.
Right. Hang about though, Dad.
What?
He did promise us another 5,000 when we finished.
Oh, God.
Just imagine what we could do with 10 grand.
You're right, son. It's worth taking a chance. Now, the first thing to do is have another drink.
I've just been thinking. I bet we could get some curtains from upstairs in a great big house like this.
Now, that is intelligent. I always said there was a spark inside there.
somewhere.
Just a pretty face, Dad, am I?
No. Off you go, then, and sort out a couple of decent pairs.
Right, Dad. What are you going to do?
Me? I'll be having a shifty around for some wrapping paper.
Right.
One of those.
Check it. Funny thoughts just occur to me. Not that I'm famous for my sense of humour.
True.
True.
Make me old mum laugh. Supposing we were to take this opportunity of getting rid of Jock Fraser and Mr. Constantine.
Commit a little mayhem on them, you mean?
Yeah, something like that. A terminal attack of falling downstairs or whatever.
I like it.
I like it.
Yeah, Dudley. You sure that last anchovy twirl was all right?
Tastes all right to me, Chief.
Well, if I go, you go first. He must work for the National Elf Service. I just made a joke, boys.
Sorry, Chief.
Sorry, Chief.
Good evening,
sir. Good evening, Constable.
Mr. Filth!
Sure, it's under the snow.
Hello, hello, hello. You don't look like old Humphreys.
Who?
Old Humphreys, Sir Henry's butler.
You're dead right, Constable. Very observant of you. I don't look like him at all.
I take it you're a guest then, sir.
Right on the button.
Nice of you to invite me in, sir.
Oi, oi, Clod.
Hold enough out there to make a brass monkey look highly apprehensive, sir.
Very nice of you to drop in, Constable. Mustn't keep me from my duties.
Oh, bless your little old heart, sir. You're a townie, aren't you? We don't take no notice of any duties down here. Especially around Christmas time. No, you tell Sir Henry as how his breathalyzer fixes here. I could have had him 9 times this year. Wouldn't do it. Not with him being chairman of the bench of magistrates and captain of the cricket team.
Who is it, Nico?
This police officer wants us to assist him in his inquiries after Sir Henry.
Oh. I'm afraid he's not here at the moment. His cousin.
Oh.
And he has very kindly given me the use of his house for a few days.
Typical. Typical of the man, that is. Soul of generosity. Never a Christmas goes by without he invites me in for a couple of 3 brandies. Tottery, says, you must pop in and sink a drink with me. Now, you wouldn't want to break with tradition, sir, would you?
Certainly not. No, you just stay there and I'll go and get you a drink.
I wouldn't dream of it, sir.
You wouldn't?
Definitely not. Can't have a toff like you waiting on humble village bobby like me. You just let me at the sideboard, sir. I'll help myself. Take advice from a policeman, sir. Never booze on an empty stomach. Don't let me interrupt your jollifications. Nice to see a bunch of law-abiding citizens enjoy themselves. We've got a little saying down here. When the drink spills over the top of your glass, by closing time, you're flat on your back. Here's to crime.
That long arm of the law is all at elbow.
Get down to me, I'll join the bicycle. Now then, Jock. Like, I wonder now I knew that. Well, it's my trained powers of observation. Once I spotted them funny trousers, I deduced you was a Scotty. What you doing with that, then?
This, I was going outside for a slash.
I just remember that, by you.
What are we going to do about that policeman?
Oh, I don't suppose he'll stay long, Mr. C.
You fool. He cannot leave this house alive. He can identify us all. He must be disposed of immediately.
Georgie?
Idiot! Colette, my dear. Could you spare a moment?
Excuse me. Oui, chérie?
Do something for me. Entice our policeman friend out of the room. You know how nervous uniforms make me.
Of course, sweetheart.
Oh, you wouldn't believe it, sir.
Oh, ta.
The amount of crime we get down here. Some real villains about. Poachers. People drinking after hours. Kids riding their bikes without lights. I blame it on the telly myself. Well, I must be off. In the immortal words of Gilbert O'Sullivan, a policeman's lot is not a happy one. Night all.
What is your hurry, officer? The night is young. I let you into a little secret. The best brandy is outside in the hall. Come and have a glass with me, no?
Oh, now how could I turn down an invite like that? I never could resist a smash a bit of crackling, as the old boar said to the young sow.
Come away from the door.
Huh?
Over there. Now that we are alone, there is something I must show you.
Oh. My crikey, this is hardly the time and place. Why don't you meet me later down by the bottom spinny?
You have hold of the wrong end of the stick. I am Inspector Claire Harper of the Yard, working on an undercover operation.
Hell's fire. This is the first time I've ever fancied an inspector.
What is your name?
Tozer, sir. A man.
Listen closely, Tozer. You are about to get the sort of opportunity that every copper worth his salt longs for.
Not cup final duty.
Every person in that room is a vicious and dangerous criminal. The three top London gangs assembled under one roof. Never before. This is the chance of a lifetime. You can see what you and I have to do.
By thunder, I do. We must lay down the phone box and call for help.
There's no time for that. We must strike without delay.
Oh, I'd love to help, ma'am. Really, I would. But I got this old football injury, you see.
Pull yourself together, man. Don't you want to be promoted? Surely you want to go up?
Of course I do. So long as it's not all the way up.
Just follow my lead and we'll have them in the nick in no time. Oh, and you better get your truncheon out.
I've never ever used this except for cracked walnuts.
What the hell's the idea of inviting the old Bill in here? I'm allergic to them baskets.
No more than me, I can assure you.
You'd better get him out of this house quick, or I'll not be able to restrain my lads.
Everything will be taken care of.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you please, I have an announcement of great interest to you all. Nobody move, I am a police officer, get your hands up.
There you are, son. I was just coming to look for you.
Got a nice curtains, Dad, look.
Yeah, good boy. What these will do nicely. Sounds as though they're in there. We'll go in, give them the presents, cop the other 5,000, and away off home. Right?
Right, Dad.
Colette, how could you deceive me like this?
Because you're a damn fool. It wouldn't have happened to me, I could tell you.
Merry Christmas, one and all.
I'm afraid three of them got away, ma'am.
It can't be helped, Tozer. We may have lost the leaders, but at least we've rounded up this nasty little bunch. You two, over there with the others. Move! I am Inspector Claire Harper of the Yard, and you are all under arrest.
You've no need to arrest me, officer. I'm Sergeant Campbell, Glasgow, CID.
Glad to have you aboard, Sergeant.
It's a pity we didn't know that before, Sergeant.
Constables Pring and Clayton, usual crimes.
Ridiculous. Been a right lack of communication here.
Sergeant Palmer, special branch.
Merry Christmas.
I'll see you later.
Dobson Whitworth, flying squad.
Yes, Sweeney.
Detective Sergeant Willoughby Soames, and assistant, special patrol group.
Got a few of our lines crossed, but at least we've got that evil old crone.
Wrong again, Inspector.
DC Sykes, Basingstoke Central. Took Charlie's mum's place 7 years ago when she went inside.
That's a damn clever disguise. It's all me.
All right, you two. Which force are you from?
We're not coppers, lady.
Then what are you doing here?
And we're working for that Mr. Constantine.
Doing what?
What he is trying to say is...
All right, all right. I can explain. I'm not stupid. That Mr. Constantine promised us 10,000 quid to do the job. No questions asked. in our own time. So long as we made sure it was curtains for Mr. Coffin and Mr. Fraser.
Hired killers, eh? Campbell,
cover. All right, lads, grab them.
Help!
I think I've got it wrong again.
We'll be right back.